Kurunji Senior Secondary School, CBSE, Namakkal.
Successful, result-producing school in state every year.
Administered by the Board of Directors with over 35 years of experience in the teaching field.
Special attention on art, craft, music, dance, silambam, yoga, skating and karate.
Focus on Hindi Sabha and Spell Bee Olympiad exams.
Smart class for effective and innovative learning and well-furnished library.
Solitary importance on sports and games in state and national level.
WhatsApp facilities to know activities of students and school inside the campus.
NEET, JEE, IIT coaching experts from Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh along with our effective teachers.
Admission, registration for classes LKG to plus 2.
Kurunji Educational Institution, Kavetipatti, Namakkal. Admission in progress. CBSE, KG to 12th, contact 9025895176. Metric, 6 to 12th, contact 9344567484. For online admission, log on to www.kurunjischoolnkl.in.
L is equal to 39.5 centimeters. S is equal to Y is equal to 12.5 ohms. That is what they have given, we have written. As S is equal to 100 minus small l by small l into capital R. L is the length where we got the balance point and R is the resistance, right? Okay, so now we are going to substitute. 12.5 is equal to 100 minus 39.5 divided by 39.5 into capital R. So if we complete this mathematical process, you know, 100 minus 39.5 means we are getting 60.5, right? So R is equal to 12.5 into 39.5 divided by 60.5, which will give us 8.16 ohm. He is asking to determine, no? So asking to determine the resistance of X, right? That is what this is, the resistance, okay? Right, here the notation is X he is showing, but anyhow here it will be R. It will be R, right? S is equal to Y is equal to 12.5 ohms and R is equal to X is equal to. R is equal to X is equal to, that is what, 8.16, ma. That's what we found, that is 8.16 ohm, right? Next, why are the connections between resistors in a Wheatstone or metal bridge made of thick copper strips? That is the question. So what is the answer here? You know, connections are made by thick copper strips to minimize the resistances of connections which are not accounted for in the above formula. So why we are using thick copper, right? Why we are using thick copper strip means to minimize the resistances of connections. To minimize the resistances of connections, so that which will not accountable for the above formula, right? That is the main reason. Next, determine the balance point of the bridge above if X and Y are interchanged, right? See, when X and Y are interchanged, you know, R is equal to Y is equal to 12.5 ohm, S is equal to X is equal to 8.16 ohm. S is equal to X is equal to 8.16 ohm. L is equal to question mark, right? That's what we have to find out. Now, S is equal to 100 minus L. 100 minus L by L into R. 100 minus L by L into R. Okay. Ippo, see, interchange, no? When interchanged, R is equal to Y is equal to, and X is equal, right? See, S is equal to 100 minus L by L into R. Now we are going to substitute. 8.16 is equal to 100 minus L by L into 12.5. R, see, 8.16L is equal to 1250 minus 12.5L. 12.5L. Okay, right. Because it is 125 by 10, you can write. So that we are getting 1250 here. Finally, if you try to find out the value of L, that will become like 60.5 centimeters from the end A. See, how we got that value? L is equal to 1250. L is equal to 1250 divided by 20.66. 20.66, that is equal to 60.5 centimeters. 60.5 centimeters from the end A. 60.5 centimeters from the end A. Right, now next. Next problem. See, it is what? Problem number 10. Problem number 10 completed, no? Right. Ipo next next continuation problem. That is what problem number 11. See here. A storage battery of EMF. A storage battery of EMF 8 volts. A storage battery of EMF 8 volts and the internal resistance 0.5 ohms is being charged by a 120 volt DC supply using a series resistor of 15.5 ohms, right? What is the terminal voltage of the battery during charging? What is the purpose of having a series resistor in the charging circuit? Okay, right. A small correction here. Before going to explain this problem, I'll explain. See here, what happens if the galvanometer and cell are interchanged at the balance point of the bridge? Would the galvanometer show any current, right? So first we have to answer this, because I didn't write here, but I'll tell you. After completion of this, we'll go for 11th as usually, right? See, third one, what happens if the galvanometer and cell are interchanged? What happens if the galvanometer and cell are interchanged? Okay, see here. What happens if the galvanometer and cell are interchanged at the balance point of the bridge? Would the galvanometer show any current? Means here, you know, when the galvanometer and cell are interchanged at the balance point, the conditions of the balanced bridge are still satisfied, and so again the galvanometer will not show any current, right? Generally at the balance point the galvanometer will show any current. Even though if you interchange galvanometer and cell, it will not affect the present situation. What is there? That is what automatically the galvanometer will show zero current. That is what it is showing before, right? So you can say that the galvanometer will not show any current, right? That is the answer for this third one, right? Next, 11th question. See here, right? 11th question. A storage battery of EMF 8 volts and internal resistance 0.5 ohms is being charged by a 120 volts DC supply using a series resistor of 15.5 ohms. What is the terminal voltage of the battery during charging? What is the terminal voltage of the battery during charging? What is the purpose of having a series resistor? What is the purpose of having a series resistor in the charging circuit? Okay, right. Ipo, see here. When the storage battery of 8 volts is charged with a DC supply of 120 volts, then what is the net EMF in the circuit? It will be epsilon dash is equal to 120 minus 8.0, which is 112 volt. Current in the circuit during charging I is equal to, right, that is epsilon dash by R plus R, that is equal to 112 divided by 15.5 plus 0.5. So 15.5 plus 0.5 means evla, which is 16, no? Right. 112 by 16 means, which will give us, you know, 7 amps. So 7 amps is the current in the circuit during charging. 7 amps is the current in the circuit during charging, right? Next, the terminal voltage of the battery during charging, V is equal to epsilon plus IR, no? V is equal to epsilon plus IR, that is equal to 8.0 plus 7 into 0.5 is equal to 11.5 volt, right? 7 into 0.5 means it is 3.5, no? So 3.5 plus 8.0 is equal to 11.5 volts. So 11.5 volts is the terminal voltage of the battery during charging. Okay, right. In this problem, you know, they have given a storage battery of EMF 8 volts and internal resistance 0.5 ohms is being charged by a 120 volts DC supply using a series resistor of 15.5 ohms. Right? Okay. What is the terminal voltage of the battery during charging? That is the first thing we have to find. And what is the purpose of having a series resistor? What is the purpose of having a series resistor in the charging circuit? In the charging circuit, right? So two things we have to find. One is, what is the terminal voltage of the battery during charging? Another one is, what is the purpose of having a series resistor in the charging circuit, right? That is the second one, right? See, first one, see, when a storage battery of 8 volts is charged with a DC supply of 120 volts, the net EMF will be like 112 volts. That is what, 120 minus 8.0 will give us 112 volts. So epsilon dash is equal to 112 volt. Next, current in the circuit during charging, I is equal to epsilon dash by R plus R, that is equal to 112 divided by 15.5 plus 0.5, that is 7 amps. Next, the terminal voltage of the battery during charging, V is equal to epsilon plus IR. So when it is epsilon plus IR, see, epsilon already they have given 8 volts, that is a storage battery of EMF 8 volts plus 8 volts, right, plus 7 into 0.5, 7 is the I value, that's what we calculated, and 0.5 is the internal resistance they have given, so that here we are getting 11.5 volts as the terminal voltage of the battery during charging, okay, right. Ipo, next, one more thing is there. What is the purpose of having a series resistor? What is the purpose of having a series resistor in the charging circuit? In the charging circuit, okay, right. The series resistor limits the current drawn from the external source, okay, right, full stop. In its absence, the current will be dangerously high, okay. I'll repeat once again, the series resistor limits the current drawn from the external source. If there is no limit, what will happen? Current will be dangerously high, right? When the current will be dangerously high, the total circuit will get damaged, no? That is the major problem. That is the reason he connected a resistor in series in the charging circuit. Here you can see, right? That is the resistor he connected in series in the charging circuit, okay? That is very important, because in our daily life also, sometimes you can see this. Okay, because we don't want to damage our TV, we don't want to damage our circuit, that is what electrical circuit which is present in our house. Sometimes we can see that the short circuit, right? Sometimes you can see that total electrical devices which are present in our house should be safe, right? Because it is somewhat cost, no, economy, that's why. So finally, what I am saying is, here for the safety of circuit, he connected a resistor in the charging circuit. That is the purpose. Okay, right. Next problem. Another problem, 12th problem. See here. In a potentiometer arrangement, a cell of EMF, 1.25 volts, gives a balance point at 35.0 centimeters length of the wire. Full stop. If the cell is replaced by another cell and the balance point shifts to 63.0 centimeters. Right. Ipu, what is the EMF of the second cell? So in this problem, he is asking to calculate EMF of the second cell. There are two cells. When there is a first cell of EMF 1.25 volts, which gives a balance point at 35.0 centimeters length of the wire. If the cell is replaced by another cell and the balance point shifts to 63.0 centimeters, right, full stop. What is the EMF of the second cell? What is the EMF of the second cell? Right, that is. Now, see, first we are going to write the given datum. That is, epsilon 1 is equal to 1.25 volt. L1 is equal to 35.0 centimeters, L2 is equal to 63.0 centimeters, and epsilon 2 is equal to question mark, right. From the discussion of potentiometer theory, right, there we got epsilon is directly proportional to L, right? When epsilon is directly proportional to L, you can write epsilon 1 by epsilon 2 is equal to L1 by L2, no? Right. You can also write epsilon 2 by epsilon 1 is equal to epsilon 2 by epsilon 1 is equal to L2 by L1, L2 by L1, right? So now I am going to write epsilon 2 as a subject. So epsilon 2 is equal to L2 by L1 into epsilon 1, L2 by L1 into epsilon 1, that is equal to, see L2 is 63 centimeters, no, 63 into 1.25, epsilon 1 is 1.25 divided by L1 is 35 centimeters, L1 is 35 centimeters, okay, right. Ipo L1 is 35 centimeters, that is equal to 2.25 volt, right, which is 2.25 volt. 63 into 1.25 divided by 35 is equal to 2.25 volts. Epsilon 2 by epsilon 1 will become as 2. Epsilon 2 will become, because epsilon 2 by epsilon 1 means this is the value, that is L2 by L1, L2 by L1, L2 by L1 means 63 by 35, but here he is asking to find epsilon 2, not the ratio of epsilon 1 by epsilon 2 or epsilon 2 by epsilon 1. He is asking what is the value of epsilon 2. So to calculate what is the value of epsilon 2, first from this relation we have to write epsilon 2 as a subject. So epsilon 2 is equal to L2 by L1 into epsilon 1, L2 by L1 into epsilon 1 is equal to 63 into 1.25 divided by 35 is equal to 2.25 volt, 2.25 volts. Epsilon 2 by, epsilon 2 will become as 2.25 volt, 2.25 volt, okay, that is right. Now next one, here next problem, the number density of free electrons, next problem, another problem, 13th problem, the number density of free electrons in a copper conductor, in a copper conductor, the number density of free electrons in a copper conductor is 8.5 into 10 to the power of 28 per meter cube, per meter cube, full stop. How long does an electron, how long does an electron take to drift, from one end of a wire 3 meters long to its other end, okay. How long does an electron take to drift from one end of a wire 3 meters long to its other end, right? Here the area of cross section of the wire is, they have given as 2.0 into 10 to the power of minus 6 square meter, and it is carrying a current of 3 amps, okay, right. See, first, they have given number density of free electrons in a copper conductor as 8.5 into 10 to the power of 28 per meter cube. That's what you can write here. N is equal to 8.5 into 10 to the power of 28 per meter cube. And length of the wire they have given as 3 meters. L is equal to 3 meters. And area of cross section given as 2.0 into 10 to the power of minus 6 square meter. E is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulombs. That's what we know already. And I is equal to 3 amps. I is equal to 3 amps. Okay, right. Ipo, first drift speed. See, the formula for drift speed, Vd is equal to I by NEA, I by NEA. See, I value is 3 amps divided by N value is 8.5 into 10 to the power of 28. E value is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19. A value is 2 into 10 to the power of minus 6. 2 into 10 to the power of minus 6 square meter, right. Finally, if you complete this, if you substitute the units of all these four things, finally you will get it as meter per second. Right. Here, drift speed Vd is equal to 1.1 into 10 to the power of minus 4 meter per second. Okay. Next, required time. See, finally he is asking to calculate required time. Required time T is equal to L by Vd, no? See, what is the L, ma? Length of the conductor. It is 3 meters, no? See here, 3 meters divided by Vd value just now we calculate, which is 1.1 into 10 to the power of minus 4. 1.1 into 10 to the power of minus 4, that is equal to 2.73 into 10 to the power of 4 seconds, which is approximately equal to 7.57, right? It is not 757, ma, which is 7.57 hours, that is the required time, okay, right. So in this class we discussed 4 problems, 10th, 11th, 12th and 13th, okay. So in our next class we will continue with the next continuation problem, that is problem number 14, okay, ma? Right, thank you.